Вторая сессия межвузовской конференции «We speak legal English» – French, Spanish, German and Chinese – с участием наших партнеров была также интересна, как и все предыдущие конференции.
Dear professors, dear participants and guest of honor, we're glad to welcome you at annual PFUR conference. We speak legal English, German, French, Spanish, and as far as I can see, Chinese. So everything that we want to say is about regulations of time, again.
And we would like to remind you that we are restricted in time, and remember, you have only 5 minutes to make your presentation.
Wir sind froh, alle zu unserer Konferenz. Wir sprechen Jurasprache begrüßen zu dürfen. Es ist eine gute Tradition geworden, Anfang Winter diese zu starten. Wir wünschen allen einen großen Erfolg und möchten nur ein paar Regeln einer effizienten Präsentation erfrischen. Wer versteht schon Juristen Deutsch? Manchmal nicht einmal die Juristen selbst. Nur wer genau weiß, was er vermitteln will, kann sich kurz und verständlich ausdrücken. Klarer Inhalt und gute Sprache gehen Hand in Hand. Es geht um die richtigen Wörter und die richtigen Sätze. Ausgewogenheit zwischen Präzision und Verständlichkeit. Je klarer die Rechtssprache ist, umso verlässlicher ist das Recht, sicherer die Bürgerfreiheit und höher die Rechtskultur.
First, we would like to give the floor to the PhD student of Faculty of Law, who would like to share her experience in legal English learning and
university last year. And have you ever thought what is English for you? Why you are here? Why do you need English? You want to have a diploma and be an ordinary lawyer? Is that all? Is it the only purpose of your studying here? But you study in People's Friendship University of Russia. You have a great opportunity to get 2, 3 or more diplomas. Well, I will show you mine. Here are they. English and French. You need to remember that every day you meet languages. Do you know the translation of what is written to your t-shirts? No, I don't see anybody. But do you read it? I don't think so. But how can you wear these t-shirts without knowledge of the translation? I'm sure that the translation is correct. Yeah, when you will be third year student, you will have such a subject as international law. What will you do if you need to analyze some documents which exist only in English? But you must analyze these documents. Otherwise, you want to get A, you will get F or FX, yes?
FX, yes.
That shows a round table, and every day I have tasks of translation in different languages, some recommendations or some different letters to our colleagues in Europe. So, everything is your hands, and please study and learn for languages for your
вам представить своего переводчика, студентку второго курса Мишланову Валерию. Фундянде, двоесим, путхунде, чуфа. Одинаковые преступления, разные наказания. Дэйши, дэйшан, мэйкен, дол йоу, фань, дзэй, мушан. Мэйсян, дзэйсин, бисю, шоу, дауч, халфа. Каждый день в мире совершаются преступления, и каждый из них должно быть наказан. Мы гагудя да гаджун фан цзуй, йоу бутхун да чхуфа. Динхен цзуй чхан дзен да чхан фа ши дзен динь. каждой стране преступления наказываются по-разному. На сегодняшний день самый распространенный вид наказания – это тюремное заключение.
За юнгу шедай день хан сва юн дэчхэн фа шэ цэсим. День тян цэсим зу вэй и джун чэн фа сэн шэ джэй цун зай. Ли ру зай вэ ло сэ кэй пхан джэ цэсим, дан шэ бим бу джэ сэн цэсим.
В древние времена наиболее распространенным наказанием являлась смертная казнь. Она и сейчас присутствует. Например, в России смертная казнь как вид наказания присутствует, но на ее исполнение наложен
мораторий.
А в городе Джанчжоу, провинции Хэнань, жил молодой человек, которого звали Ши Ванзе. После того, как он бросил школу, он всерьез увлекся всемирной паутиной и начал воровать деньги из дома и просиживать их в интернете. В 2008 году через интернет он познакомился с девушкой и влюбился.
Unter Doping versteht man die Einnahme von unerlaubten Substanzen oder die Nutzung von unerlaubten Methoden zur Steigerung der sportlichen Leistung. Dies ist im Sport weitestgehend verboten, weil die Anwendung von Dopingmitteln zu einer ungleichen Chancenverteilung im sportlichen Wettbewerb führt. Ob Doping verboten ist, muss in der Verbands- der Vereinssatzung geregelt sein. Ohne Regelung wäre Doping erlaubt und könnte von Mitwettbewerbern allenfalls als unlauterer Wettbewerb gemäß § 3 Gesetz gegen den unlauteren Wettbewerb angegriffen werden.
Sie wurde 1999 als Ergebnis einer vom Internationales Olympisches Komitee initiiert, Weltdoping-Konferenz mit dem Ziel gegründet, die Anti-Doping-Programme auf internationaler und nationaler Ebene in Hinsicht auf die Entdeckung, Abschreckung und Verhinderung von Doping zu harmonisieren und koordinieren.
So, good morning, good afternoon actually, ladies and gentlemen. The topic of my presentation is English law usage in Russian corporate law. So, it's common knowledge that law is widely used in international English law actually is widely used in international transactions, often in combination with local laws. Moreover, the English language is of course also generally known as the main language of international business globally and the main language of the internet. So let's think, why English is so popular all over the world? First of all, English common law system means a combination of legislation and case precedent. This makes exactly this law system very flexible and adaptable to the world's processes and needs in the business. Compared with the Russian law system, which cannot provide that level of flexibility, as the Russian Federation civil codes and a number of federal laws are the main sources of settlements at the offshore level. The company's assets will be owned by a Russian subsidiary so that it is under the security of Russian law.
About the federal security of the Russian Federation. The federal security service is a unified central system of federal security service organs resolving the tasks of safeguarding the security of the Russian Federation within the limits of its competence. The Federal Security Service of the Russian Federation is made up of departments, directors, and other subdivisions working directly in the operational fields of agencies of the Federal Security Service, as well as subdivisions performing directive functions. The directors of the Russian FSS for separate regions and components of the Russian Federation, the Territorial Security Agency.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Maria Chinyan, and today I'm going to tell you about guerrilla marketing. So, we all know who guerrillas are. You can see them on the screen, on the pictures. Guerrilla warfare is a form of warfare in which a small group of combatants use military tactics, which include the element of surprise, extraordinary ability to harass a larger and less mobile army, and to withdraw almost immediately. Guerrilla marketing is an advertising strategy in which low-cost and conventional means are used to convey or promote product or idea. The concept of guerrilla marketing was invented as a unconventional system of promotions that relies on time, energy, and imagination rather than a big marketing budget. Typically, we can see there are some points which the concept of guerrilla marketing applies by J. Conrad Levinson in his book. And you can see the focus of guerrilla marketing is on low cost strategies. Money is not very important. He got plenty of money for this advertisement. Then we have buzz marketing. As we have, I think. Tissue bag marketing is also very interesting, and who can think? You can say when a person buys something and she or he takes a tissue or bag, the other bystanders, the other bypassers can see the logo of the advertisement on this bag, and so it is spread over the world. You better create a standard of excellence rather than a wide range of products.
Interesting. And one question, please. Are there any ads which are for this concept in Russia, in this country?
Yes, I was thinking about it. I could only remember, you know, this text on the pavement. On the pavement.
It's also.
Password.
It is also this concept, yes.
Yes, it's guerrilla marketing concept, but Russia is not very modern in this kind of advertising.
Good morning, dear colleagues and guests. The topic of my presentation is alternative dispute resolution. Alternative dispute resolution, abbreviated as ADR, includes different processes of resolving disputes outside of the judicial process, using other methods than litigation. There are generally four forms of ADR. They are mediation, arbitration, negotiation, and collaborative law. Sometimes conciliation is used as a fifth type. First of all is negotiation. Negotiation is the settlement of the dispute directly by the parties without the participation of other persons. It is almost always intended first to resolve the dispute at the primary mode of the dispute resolution. Parties can meet and discuss all their disagreements. It allows the parties to themselves to control the process and the solution. The second form is mediation. Mediation is the form of dispute settlement with the assistance of independent neutral intermediary. Mediator brings opposing parties together and tries to work out an agreement that both parties can accept or reject.
Alle begrüßen zu dürfen. Wir möchten Ihnen eine Präsentation vorstellen. Das Thema dieser Präsentation ist Hacking Tools in Deutschland. Also, wir haben dieses Thema gewählt, weil es aktuell und problematisch ist. Wir haben festgestellt, dass Computerkriminalität im engeren Sinne die Bezeichnung für Straftaten, besonders der Wirtschaftskriminalität, bei denen der Computer als Tatmittel oder als Gegenstand der deliktischen Handlungen eine wesentliche Rolle spielt, ist
Schaden anrichten. Sagte ein Sprecher von Haus Computer Club, Andy Müller-Martin, gegenüber als Techniker, die außerdem angaben, dass die Polizei unter dem neuen Gesetz befugt sein wird, leichter an Informationen über Verdächtige heranzukommen.
Also, es bleibt nur zu hoffen, dass sich der Bundestag mit dem Gesetzesentwurf noch einmal gründlich beschäftigt und einen vernünftigen Interessensausgleich.
I would like to present you a report, the theme which is relations between US and Iran, and the international legal point of view. In our modern time, the upcoming conflict between US and Iran basically touches everybody's life, even of those who sit here at this moment. So I would like to share some information and thoughts about this theme with you. As the US analyst David Rutkoff predicts, the war between US and Iran will start as soon as possible, maybe even in the next few weeks. According to him, the recent Israel Iran one step from an attack on Iran. Basically, everybody of us knows the formula of the new era upcoming conflict. You don't need any basic weapons. All you need is a nuclear bomb. So what we have to wait, what we have to accept is a pretty simple thing: the nuclear exchange. What's the situation now? Here's the situation. U.S. government cannot be sure that there are no weapons of such type in the Iran for now. So what they are doing, they are just trying to provoke Iran, as well as today's Iran president Ahmadinejad, to start a conflict for themselves, so they could get, so they gain both costs and justification.
Student of Russian Law Academy. My topic is information security legislation in the United Kingdom. Information systems are being developed nowadays all over the world and in Russia as well. To improve safety level of Russian information systems on legislation level, we should look at foreign experience. So today, I want to tell you about such legislation in UK. Primary legal acts concerning the information security in UK. The first is Data Protection Act 1998. The second is Freedom of Information Act 2000. And the third is Computer Misuse Act 1990. You can see their short characteristic on the screen. Well, Data Protection Act 1998. It is a new act of the Parliament of the United Kingdom. The act covers personal data relating to living individuals and defines a category of sensitive personal data which are subject to more stringent conditions on their processing than other personal data. Most of the act does not apply to domestic use, for example, keeping a personal address book.
Bonjour. Le sujet de notre intervention est l'examen des différents des normes de demande à nos pays. L'un des domaines de l'activité de la communauté internationale les plus actifs sont les tentatives de protéger la propriété intellectuelle. Maintenant, quand l'Internet est devenu une partie de la vie quotidienne, ces tentatives tâchent la création et l'utilisation d'un nom de domaine. Et premièrement, je dois donner la définition d'un nom de domaine. Un nom de domaine est un ensemble de...
Les noms de domaine en plein air sont possibles. La procédure est engagée par l'envoi de la plainte par le plein air. En règle générale, la Commission prend une décision dans les 14 jours de sa formation. À tout stade de la procédure et aussi avant ou après la procédure, les parties peuvent saisir un tribunal ou une autre instance compétente. Ainsi, les activités de l'UNPI guidant sur le RUDN sont basées sur la confiance et la reconnaissance de la compétence professionnelle des membres des commissions et la simplicité de la procédure. Cette approche sur la possibilité de mettre en œuvre les principaux avantages de procédure UDRP. La vitesse d'examen, le bon marché relatif et la possibilité
de... Сравнение норм права Китая и России. Чонгок, философ, халюб, гуйян, дальше йоу сян тон дэ мог яо, жигэму гяо, джуши, тхяо джин, шихой гуанси. Законодательство Китая и России различается, но имеет общую цель. Это цель регулирования общественных отношений.
Динтьен, муяо, джишао, ися, и женши, джонгок, элосы, фагуэ, дэдой, би.
Сегодня Ксения хочет рассказать нам об одном деле и сравнить на этом примере нормы права Китая и России.
А лин лин лунье, и ганан рэн лай дао лан жоу, ютха дэ нюб хэньо джао сяо хон, хо ар рэн хон джу.
В 2006 году один мужчина приехал в Ланчжоу к своей подруге по имени Сяо Хон, после чего они стали проживать вместе.
А лин лин чи ньен, ши и юе ары, ха дэ нюб хэньо, ин бин джу юэн, Джиганан Рен, Чхэн Хаден Куньо, Шуака, Джао Фэй Го, Чхэн Джо, Ляо Тье, Инхан Хаден Ма. Джихо, Хаден Куньо, Шуе Дэ Шихо, Хадао Зо, Инхан Хай, Джан Ханэй, Иван Юэн, Чен Бун, Чу Чу, Хоу Рен Джен Джен Фа.
2 ноября 2007 года его подруга легла в больницу. И этот мужчина в этот момент, когда его подруга производила оплату с помощью банковской карты, подсмотрел пароль, после чего он перевел с карты селфон 18 900 юаней.
Я разговариваю с представителями Саратовской юридической, Государственной юридической академии. Они вот буквально только-только вышли после своего выступления. Хотел бы спросить об их впечатлениях о наших конференциях.
Очень было интересно участвовать в таком виде мероприятий, особенно быть здесь, в Российском университете дружбы народов. Спасибо за предоставленную возможность участвовать в такой конференции, обсуждать многие проблемы не только в сфере права, но даже некоторые политические вопросы. Мы хотим сказать большое спасибо организаторам данной конференции и желаем успехов дальнейшим участникам.
Спасибо большое.
Да, надеемся, что будете продолжать приглашать нас. Очень приятно было участвовать, на самом деле, спасибо за приглашение. Нам очень понравились все доклады, очень высокий уровень всех докладчиков, очень интересные темы, острые, социально-политические, правовые. Спасибо вам.
Спасибо большое. Спасибо. Будем дальше на следующих наших.
Спасибо.